point that every time there is a rape, I go and meet that girl. Because I really want to internalize that pain. I think her pain should be my pain, and only then we will be able to probably fight for this kind of a thing. So we tried to find out, why is it that Delhi is known as the rape capital of the world? As DCW chief, I summoned him to the police commissioner because they were not giving us data. And when I summoned him and when I got the data, I was quite shocked. Because between 2012 to 14, 31,446 crimes against women were registered in the capital, and less than 150 were convicted. So 31,000 crime hote hain, aur 150 se kam logon ko sazaein hoti hain. No wonder nobody is scared in the capital. And this is a scenario which we are experiencing everywhere. As DCW chief, hum log zameen se utarte hain, bahut jagah jaate hain, kabhi kahin ja rahe hain, kabhi kahin ja rahe hain. Jahan bhi hum ja rahe hain, ek cheez samajh mein aati hai ki kisi ko koi dar nahi hai. Mere saamne khule mein अवैध शराब बिकते हुए मैंने पकड़वाई है. People are not scared. जब उनको पकड़वाया 400-400 बोतल शराब की जो बिल्कुल अवैध है, घरों में बिक रही है, गांजा घरों में बिक रहा है, जब हम ये पकड़वाते हैं तो वो सामने मेरे मुंह पे कहते हैं कि तुम कहाँ से आ गए, हम तो पुलिस को हफ्ता देते हैं. तो इस तरीके की चीजें हम रिकॉर्ड पे भी लेकर आए हैं. एंड इट्स वेरी सैड दैट पीपल आर नॉट स्केयर्ड इन दिल्ली. एंड आई थिंक दैट इज व्हाट नीड्स टू चेंज. फर्दर वी एनालाइज दिस एंटायर सिचुएशन. The police, Delhi police for the past 10 years has been demanding 66,000 police personnel from the centre, and they haven't even got one in the past 10 years. As a result, when you go down on the streets, when you go down on the streets of Delhi and when you go to the police stations, you will realise that each and every police station is functioning at half its sanctioned strength. So they are being able to do the duty of VIPs, but they really can't do the duties of the janta, because अगर उनके पास आधा ही स्ट्रेंथ है, एंड इवन देयर सैंक्शन स्ट्रेंथ इज वेरी लेस, इट इज एक्सट्रीमली लेस, एंड इवन दैट टू दैट दे हैव ओनली हाफ द स्ट्रेंथ, 9.5% वुमेन ऑफिसर्स इन द पुलिस. ऑब्वियसली दिस नीड्स टू बी इंक्रीज्ड. सो दिस 66,000 पुलिस फोर्सेस नीड्स टू बी इंक्रीज्ड, एंड वी आर ट्राइंग टू वर्क फॉर दैट. द अदर थिंग इज द पुलिस अकाउंटेबिलिटी. फॉर द पास्ट 10 इयर्स द सेंटर इज ट्राइंग टू क्रिएट अ सॉफ्टवेयर टू डिजिटाइज द फंक्शनिंग ऑफ द पुलिस फोर्स अक्रॉस द कंट्री. It's really very strange that in this digital India, we are not having that software even now. So the police commissioner right in the morning doesn't know that which particular SHO is performing, which SHO is not performing, where are the crimes against women which are more. Everything is coming in files and archive mechanisms through which he's not able to fix accountability then and there. Also, we discover that whenever there is a problem, if we find that, okay, some police officer has not performed well, or that the maximum that they do is they transfer. So I think accountability of police needs to be increased. Apart from that, we issued a notice to the forensic laboratory in Delhi, and we realized that 1,500 samples have been putrefied. Now, who's responsible for that? They could be gang rape samples, they could be child rape samples. Obviously, that needs to be fixed. The number of fast track courts in Delhi is really unfortunate. They are really less. Though after the Nirbhaya, gang rape and murder of Nirbhaya, we had fast track courts that were set up, but they are not functioning in a fast track court manner. We need many more fast track courts. Now, all of this is required, and the Delhi Commission for Women, we have been appealing to the centre to do one thing. Set up a high level committee. I think it is very crucial, because Delhi being a special state, there are certain things that come under the Delhi government, there are certain things that come under the centre government, then there is an office of the LG, and as a result, there is a lot of confusion, which I'm sure as students of media you must be observing very closely. So I think it is important that we have a high level committee in Delhi, which consists of the Home Minister of the country, because he is the direct political head of the Delhi Police, the Chief Minister, the LG, the Police Commissioner, and DCW. And I really think that we need to meet at least 2 times in a month to be able to resolve these issues. I think, because now we are demanding this, and I think it is crucial that this happens, we need to have a strong and stringent system. There needs to be fear amongst criminals. And for that, we are demanding that within 6 months, at least in the cases of child rapes, those rapists should be given the death penalty within 6 months. So there needs to be some deterrence, because right now the situation is such that nobody is scared, nobody is concerned, and that is what we need to change. Now, I've gone to the court, I have met leaders, I have written to various people in authority, and I have done everything in my purview to be able to change. one year, we have handled 12,000 cases, attended 3.16 lakh calls on our 181 helpline, rescued hundreds and hundreds of women from their circumstances, whether it is GB Road or somewhere else. 7,500 grassroots visits, 5,500 we have assisted sexual assault victims in, 1,869 counseling sessions we have done, 55 recommendations to the government. This is 1 year work that I'm telling you. And we are the only commission across the country, probably one of the only government offices across the country, which functions voluntarily and officially on Saturdays also. So now doing so much of work, working day and night, despite all of that, I feel very sad because an 8-month-old baby gets raped. I go and meet her, there is silence, and I'm not able to bring about the change. So this time we have launched the Satyagraha, a peaceful movement. For the past five nights, I have not gone back home. I'm working during the day. In the evenings, I start my inspections. I'm going to various places, whether it is public toilets, whether it is places where illegal liquor is being sold, illegal drugs are being sold. We're doing all of that. And then in the night, I come back and sleep in the office only and then start the day. And this I will be doing for 30 days. Because I feel that it is high time that we all come together, whether it is students, whether it is public, whether it is the government, and try and address this issue of child rape in the capital. An 8-month-old baby being raped, if that doesn't bring reform, I really don't know what will. So we are trying to do that. We are doing this Satyagraha. And for that Satyagraha, I think each and every person who is sitting here really needs to join in too. Because this time, the Satyagraha that we are trying to do, I really believe that now it needs to convert into a people's movement. We need to be on the streets. Ek baar ek zamane mein jab Nirbhaya ke saath gangrape hua tha, I'm sure a lot of people who are sitting here, they were there at that time on Vijay Path, Vijay Chowk. I was there, I was lucky charged. I'm sure, I don't know how old you were at that time, but a lot of people were there at that time. And we all fought for a movement. And we fought for change. And yet, we are here today demanding the same things and we will do more over and over again. But I think that a movement needs to start, a public movement needs to start, and a peaceful movement needs to start. So we are planning, we are starting a movement, we are in the process of just finalizing it and designing the campaign. We are going to be demanding, we are going to get around at least 1 lakh signatures across the city. And support is really pouring in. So from the country, from outside, we try and get some signature campaigns going and we try and send it to the President and the Prime Minister and we try and appeal to him to make certain changes that we are asking for. Now, why the Satyagraha? Because despite all this, despite all the work that we have done, I think changes are not happening and that is why we are trying to do that. That is one side of my work, but because I've come here, I would also like to talk about the other aspects. There are people in this country who are able to fight for themselves. There are people in this country who are not. And Delhi also, the country's capital, also is full of people who really don't have any voice. There is a place called GB Road, right in the center of Delhi. It's a place where souls are sold. It is a place where 5,000 women from across the country, poorest of poor places, are bought and sold there. There are women who are sold for 5,000 rupees, some are sold for 10,000 rupees, you know, one time. And every day what they get, 5 rupees, 10 rupees, 15 rupees, their respect and dignity is just priced at that. It is a very, very horrifying situation. 5,000 women from the poorest of the poor places in this country, sold in this area. Most of them do not earn anything, but a lot of money is made in their name by several few people. And when we went and asked, when we started investigating as to who owns the GB Road, it's very interesting. When we asked the authorities, we asked police, they said, we don't know. We asked the DDA, they said, we don't know. So when we started investigating, we some 125 names came across. And we are in the process of investigating as to exactly who owns this GB Road, who is living, who's getting money out of this horrifying business. Every other day, we are rescuing girls in GB Road. The last girl, certain time back, we rescued a girl. She is 15 years old. She was sold at the age of 9 years. And for the past 6 years, every day she was served to 20 men. And she has stated how in the police in her police complaint, she has written how she was injected various kind of injections daily, because of which when I went and met her, I myself was shocked. Is she 15? But then when we got the bone ossification test done, she was around 14 to 16 years old. So that is her age, but because of the kind of injections that have been given to her, she even now doesn't look her age. And that is the situation in GB Road. It's really, really unfortunate. There is a police station at 100 meters from the GB Road. Somehow I get to know that a girl has been sold. The NGOs get to know that a girl has been sold. Delhi Police just doesn't ever get to know that a girl has been sold. And I really don't know why. Recently, the Child Welfare Committee, we gave them a hint and all, and we rescued around 17 girls. 17 girls were rescued in one go from GB Road. By the night, Delhi Police had sent 14 of them back, saying that they have their Aadhaar cards. Now, even the JJ Act is very categoric that Aadhaar cards are not age-proof. You know, so the Child Welfare Committee kept screaming, shouting, and then I went, and by that time, all those 14 girls had been sent back. So what is the hurry? Even Child Welfare Committee, it is a statutory body, they are saying that, you know, you please keep these girls in the proper home, we need to investigate what are their ages, and yet they are sent back. Then finally, I had to intervene, and we issued notices and all, and finally these 14 girls were then again brought back. So that is the situation we are fighting, that kind of a mafia. Once a girl is rescued from GB Road, where, I mean, you are students of media, I'm sure you would know, that these girls are put in a place called the Nadi Niketan. These are shelter homes. These are government-run shelter homes. And one day we decided that we will go and visit these shelter homes. So as an activist, I know that if I will go in the morning, there will be officers there and probably the girls will not be able to tell me the truth. So I went in the night and I went at around 8 p.m. And I was in for a shock because there were around 100 women. Most of them had become mentally ill. They were screaming, they were shouting, and there were certain women who had been just brought from GB Road. So they caught hold of me and they said, no, let's go back, just send us back to GB Road, we really don't want to be now. Because they found that condition to be even more worse than GB Road. And I think that needs to change. So we immediately drafted a very detailed report for the government, and then the government suspended 5 officers there. And every other day, every other time, me or my team are going and visiting these homes. I won't say that they become, you know, great, but yes, they are a little better. And I think we all need to, because society also needs to pull in. There needs to be more resources. There needs to be more CSR, which goes in there, so that this place actually becomes something which promotes some kind of proper care and, you know, care for these girls, because all of them are either incest victims or victims of trafficking. So that's the kind of work that we are doing. Our work is very challenging. Ever since I started investigating the GB Road, 2 criminal complaints were filed against me by the Delhi Police. We have issued 3,500 notices to the Delhi Police in 1 year. We have even summoned its commissioner because he refused to give us data. Because we are doing this kind of work, there is obviously an onslaught. 2 FIRs are registered against me right now. I'm out on bail. But we will keep the fight on and we will take it forward. What we are doing is not easy, and it comes with its share of challenges. I'm sure you must have read about or heard about the Narela incident, which happened very recently. One of our volunteers, she was paraded naked by the Indica Mafia. Because when I went there, she called us and she said that you must come, and because there is illegal liquor that is being sold and illegal drugs. 4-year-old, 5-year-old boys and girls are getting addicted to this. So we went there and we saw that in each and every home there was illegal liquor that was being sold. So finally we went in, then we just started taking the round. I saw that there is, you know, there's this lady and this man sitting with around 350, 400 bottles of liquor trying to sell it. So I immediately called the police. The police came, the police confiscated this liquor, and this lady threatened me. And in front of the police, she threatened me that, you know, we've given money to the police and we will set you right. So I was concerned for my volunteer because I was leaving, and then I told the SHO that, you know, please, I will stay, but you have to tell me whether. So he said, no, we organize everything, she will be looked after, don't worry, we keep doing these kind of drives. And my grandmother was ill, so I had to go. Then I left. After I left, the police, the Delhi police's vehicle was attacked by a mob of people incited by these people who were selling the liquor. And the woman constable was being constable and, oh my god, this is the same officer. And then I got to know that in that night, they had been beaten. Because that day the action was not taken against those perpetrators who dared to beat up the police. Next day, Praveen was raided in it. And it was said that even I will be, you know, they threatened that next will be DCW chief if we see her on the ground. If we see her, you know, doing this kind of a drive again, she will be raided in it. So that is the situation in the capital. Everywhere we are going, when we are going to the grassroots, when we are going to, you know, the villages of Delhi, when we are going to Jhoothi Basti, when we are going anywhere, there is one major issue, and that is molestation, and that is this illegal liquor being brought in from the nearby states and being sold in Delhi. So we are taking this up. There are of course challenges, and because you are students and you are students of the media, I think you have a huge responsibility. I really, really think so. I think there are very few people in this country whose profession promotes them and encourages them to do seva. I think media is one of the best ways, and the power of media is amazing. I can tell you, for instance, with DCW, on a lighter note, you know, we are a recommendatory body. Sometimes we may not exercise that kind of power, but every time I issue a notice, I give that notice, copy of that notice I give to the copy of the notice I mostly give to the press. So what happens is that notice, you know, is it gets published and says that so and so officer has been summoned, so and so officer has been called, and I think that really has an impact. And we haven't had a case of information not coming to the commission because of our partnership and because of our work with the media. Give you a small example. When I joined DCW, everybody said, "Oh my God, it's a toothless tiger. It is a place where retired politicians go." And frankly, even I felt so. Mujhe kahan bhej diya? Matlab, what is this? Where have I come? But then I read the Act, and the Act is very powerful. The Act actually gives me the power to issue arrest warrants against somebody if that person doesn't give me the required information or what I'm asking for. And even I didn't know about it. Nobody knew about it. So the moment I got to know about it, I took a legal opinion from Imra Jaisinghji and I just put it out in the press. And it was all over. That if DCW has not asked you to ask you, then you will issue arrest warrants. From that point, until today, I don't have to use arrest warrants once again. Because the message that you have to go inside, that if you are wrong, then you will issue arrest warrants to DCW. So that is the power of media. I was coming back to what I was saying. I think very few people in this country, their work, through their work, you can do seva. I'll just end by giving my own example. It's been, I think, 12 or 13 years back, I finished my college. I'm an engineer. I decided to give up my job and I decided to take up social work. Obviously, my parents and all felt that my lucky power was here. You know, they told me that I'm going to America. पढ़ाया अंग्रेजी स्कूल में पढ़ाया कॉलेज में पढ़ाया अमेरिका जाना था और ये जूही में जाने लगे सो आई फेस्ड अ लॉट ऑफ प्रॉब्लम्स एट दैट टाइम बट आई रियली बिलीव्ड इन व्हाट आई वाज डूइंग सो फॉर 10-12 इयर्स आई वाज ऑन द ग्राउंड स्ट्रगलिंग मुझे लगता था कि एक दिन में मैंने कुछ एक का भी काम करा दिया तो मेरा मतलब तो कुछ अच्छा हो गया आई यूज्ड टू फील हैप्पी एंड सैटिस्फाइड विद दैट एंड आई थिंक थ्रू दैट इयर्स ऑफ स्ट्रगल टुडे आई एम हियर डूइंग व्हाट द काइंड ऑफ वर्क दैट आई एम डूइंग It's only because of those years of struggle, only because I believed in my passion and only because I really felt that this is the way forward. So I'm not saying that all of you, you know, you need to give up your studies or anything and come into active social work. That's not what I'm saying. If any one of you decides, I'll be more than happy and I'll be very, I'll encourage you as much as I can. Just don't tell your parents or anybody else that I was the one that encouraged you because I'll start getting hate mails. But apart from that, I think, you know, as students of media, you have huge responsibility and it is really a way of doing seva. Because aap agar ek story se kuch zyada karenge, to usse aap pure desh ko hilane ki kshamta rakhte hain, sarkaron ko hilane ki kshamta rakhte hain, hum jaise logon ko hilane ki kshamta rakhte hain. Aap wo pillar hai hamare constitution ka, hamari democracy ka, ki aapke bina chal nahi sakta. Aur aaj jo sthiti hai, jis tarike se aaj samasyaen hain, बहुत सारे मीडिया हाउसेस जिस तरीके से मतलब चल रहे हैं बहुत इश्यूज हैं उसमें आप लोगों का बहुत जिम्मेदारी होती है एंड आई एम रियली रियली ग्रेटफुल वंस अगेन दैट सर हैज गिवन मी दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी आई थिंक सेवा से बहुत कुछ बदलता है बस अंत में यही करूँ कंपनी 12 साल हो गए लड़ते हुए अभी भी मेरी सैलरी 30,000 रुपये है माई हस्बैंड इज ऑल्सो एन एक्टिविस्ट हो तो बिल्कुल ही कुछ नहीं कमाता तो 30,000 रुपए में हमारी जिंदगी चल रही है और काफी खुशी से चल रही है और मुझे लगता है कि कोई प्रॉपर्टी नहीं कमाई जिंदगी में, कोई डायमंड नहीं है, बस 70,000 रुपए का मेरे पास मंगलसूत्र है, इसके सिवाय मेरे पास कुछ नहीं है। लेकिन इस देश की सबसे खुश लड़की हूँ मैं, इसके ऊपर चैलेंज कर सकती हूँ किसी को भी, क्योंकि मुझे लगता है कि जो मैं काम कर रही हूँ उससे मुझे घुमाई मिलती है और साल में 365 दिन होते हैं। अगर एक दिन भी हम किसी और के बारे में सोच के अगर एक भी काम करते हैं, और हम तो दिल्ली NCR में रहते हैं, यहाँ तो स्थिति है कि बगल के आदमी को देखे मुस्कुरा दो ये भी सोशल वर्क है। तो अगर हम थोड़ा भी सोशल वर्क शुरू करें, मैं आपको इतना गारंटी दे सकती हूँ, जो जो काम आप अपनी जिंदगी में दूसरों को सोच के करोगे और उसमें अपना नहीं रखोगे, वो आपके जो हीरे जवाहरात डायमंड गुचीज एंड ऑल ऑफ द वर्ल्ड, वो एक तरफ और ये एक काम एक तरफ, वो काम आपको जिंदगी भर करना है। और ये मैं मतलब कोई प्रवचन नहीं दे रही, समथिंग दैट रियली आई हैव एक्सपीरियंस्ड इन माय लाइफ, जब जब मुझे जिंदगी में कुछ जरूरत पड़ी तो वो अपने आप ही होता चला गया। बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया, थैंक यू सो मच।